Good morning students, once again welcome back to computer science class. In the last class already I have given introduction to your subject. So how many units you have, what is the name of the subject, what is the weight of each unit and how many units you have, and what is the examination pattern, how many practicals you have, and how many marks you have for Viva and how many marks you have for Record. That introduction part we completed in the last class. Okay, and what is the HTML also already have explained. So what is the HTML actually? HTML is a markup language. Okay, so HTML is a markup language. And what is the use of that HTML language? This language is used to design web pages. Means if you want to display any content on the browser window, that content should be a part of HTML page. So whatever pages you design by using a HTML language, all those pages can be displayed on the browser window. Okay, so HTML, what is the full form of HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Okay, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language, and this language is used to display web pages on the browser window. Okay, means if you want to display any content on the browser window, that should be the part of HTML page. Okay, whatever you write between a HTML page, that will be displayed on the browser window. So whatever web pages you have, like a Google, Yahoo, Gmail, whatever it may be, everything, every page is designed by using a HTML. Okay, so HTML, in HTML we have a different types of a tags. Using a tags only you can display content on the browser window. So today here I am going to explain you about the tags. What are the tags and how to write the tags and how to include different types of elements inside the tags. Okay, so HTML tags. Understood? HTML tags is like this. HTML. It is called as a tag. So this is a tag content actually, and this is enclosed between a angle brackets. This is called as a tag. Actually, what are the tags? See, example, in case of C programming, we have variables, decision making statements, operator, everything you have. But here HTML is a markup language. Okay, what is HTML? HTML is a markup language. So in HTML, whatever you want to write, whatever you want to display on the web page, that should be a part of a tags. Means that text should be included between a tags. Okay, so how to include that? Okay, that we will discuss. So tags are the main part of HTML pages. So whatever you want to display on the browser window, so that should be the part of tags. Actually, what are the tags? Tags are coding instructions. Okay, browser will get the instructions from the tags. Means how to display the content. If it is a image, how to display. If it is audio, how to display. Okay, so that instructions browser will get from the tags, and all the browsers are designed to read the tags. Understood? So that is why whatever you want to display on the browser window, that should be the part of the tags. Clear? Now here I will write the some rules how to write the tags. Clear? So always tags should be enclosed between a angle brackets. Example, this is a tag. Okay, so tags always enclosed between a angle brackets. This is the rule. So whenever you are writing any tag, how that tag should be? The tag should be enclosed between this angle brackets. These are called as a angle brackets. Like this you can write. This is HTML, break, head. So this is a tag, and this should be enclosed between the angle bracket. What's the first rule? Whenever you are writing any tag, that tag should be enclosed between the angle brackets. This is the first one. The second one is, second rule, tags are not case sensitive. Not case sensitive. Means, example, if you have given HTML, actually when tags maximum comes in a page, means if you have written an opening tag, then you must give the closing tag also. Okay, so this is a HTML opening tag. I can close like this. So here, opening tag is in a lowercase letters and the closing tag is in uppercase letters. Okay, this is a lowercase, this is a uppercase. Okay, so tags are not case sensitive. Means you can write a opening tag in one case, you can write closing tag is another case, and even you can mix uppercase and lowercase also. Like this. HTML. Yeah, this is a lowercase, this is uppercase. Even you can mix the lowercase and uppercase also. Clear all of you? So HTML tags are case sensitive. Case sensitive means you can mix lowercase letters and uppercase letter. You can write one tag in a lowercase letter and one tag in a uppercase letter. Okay, no errors will be displayed if you change the cases also. Next term, and as I already said, tags, you take screenshot of this, it is valid. Okay, it is valid. These are the simple things you try to note down. Okay, now the next one is, as you already said, tags comes in a pairs. Pair means like this. HTML is the opening tag, or I will give you the title, because you will get more clarity. Title is the tag and title is the closing tag. Means when you open the title tag, the action of that tag will start. When you close that, the action of that tag will be ended. Okay, so it is the opening and it is the closing. Clear? So here, what is the difference between opening tag and closing tag here? Opening tag, this is opening tag. What is the difference between the opening and closing here? Only extra, this is slash, here we do. Like this. Title. Forward slash. Okay, so if you are writing any tag, that tag should have a closing tag. And what is the difference between opening tag and closing tag? Opening tag and closing tag. What is the difference between opening and closing is, closing tag starts with forward slash. That is the difference. So whenever you give the closing tag, action of that tag will end. Okay. What it means if you are writing a closing tag? It means the action of that tag will be over. Okay, now what is the difference between opening and closing tag? Only extra forward slash you will get inside the closing tag. And most first rule is, it is angle bracket. The tag should be in a angle brackets. And the second one is, it is not case sensitive. It is not case sensitive. And the third one is, closing tag starts with forward slash. And the fourth one is, here what is the fourth one is, most of the tags, it comes in a pair. Yeah, pair. Pair means what actually? Two. Pair means what? Two. See here, if I have given HTML opening tag, this is the opening tag. Okay, so if you have given opening tag, it is a rule that you should give the closing also. Some tags are optional, later I will explain. But most of the tags comes in a pairs. Okay, most of the tags comes in a pairs. If you have given an opening tag, you have to give a closing tag also. Understand? Now, the next rule is nested tags. Nested tags. See, what are the nested tags? Nested tags means, see, one tag is there. Head. Inside the head, I will write a title. Example, ABC I have given as a title. And after that, have given a closing head. Okay, actually this is a simple tag where a header inside the head title is there. This is called as a inner tag. And this is called as a outer tag. Okay, understood? So if you are writing one tag inside another tag, then it is called as a nesting. We are writing title tag inside the head tag. Okay, so here this process is called as a nesting of tags. If you are writing a one tag inside another tag, then it is called as a nesting. Understood? So when you are writing a nesting tag, nested tags, you condition that before closing the outer tag, you are supposed to close the inner tag. Understood? What is the rule? Before closing the outer tag, you are supposed to close the inner tag. Okay, see, this is a valid statement. Okay, here I am having all these rules. HT head, inside the head and in the title. Just you try to concentrate here. Title ABC happy. And I am closing the title. After closing the title, you should close the head section. Because it is a rule. So whenever you are nesting any tag, before closing the inner tag, before closing the outer tag, you should close the inner tag. So it is valid. But here I will give you one more example. See, head next to title ABC I have given, and after this I have given a head. After the head I have closed the title. It is not valid. So according to the rules, when you are nesting any tag, before closing the outer tag, you should close the inner tag. Here what I did, before closing the inner tag, I have closed the outer tag. So this is an error. Okay, understood? If tags are nesting inside HTML, so what happened? Before closing the outer tag, you are supposed to close the inner tag first. Clear? Now, white space, next one. Next rule is white spaces are not allowed. White spaces are not allowed. What it means? See, this is a tag. Okay. Now here, once again I divide the tag. What is the difference between this tag and this tag here? This white space is a difference. So when you are writing a tag, tag should be a single one. White spaces are not allowed. Here I have given one cat space, white space are there. Such things are not. Okay, this is another rule. Now come to the one more rule. Example, if you have given a tag, this is a tag, HTML. But instead of this, I have given like this, HMTL. Actually, this tag is not there in HTML. So when browser finds any error or any tag which is not there, which is not predefined, then what happened? It won't throw any error, just it will ignore it. Okay, so that is why HTML is truly user friendly. Clear? So this is about HTML tags. So what are the HTML tags? HTML tags are coding instructions. Browsers are designed to read the HTML tags only. And all the HTML tags are predefined. Means tags are already defined. You no need to modify the tags. Just you need to use the tags and just you need to know how to display your content using that tags on the browser. So when you are writing any tags, what rules you need to follow? First one is, tag should be in angle bracket. The second one is, tags are not case sensitive. You can mix lowercase letters and uppercase letters. You won't get any error. And the third one is, if any tag is open, the tag must be closed, because in HTML, most of the tags comes in a space. Next, white spaces are not allowed. Tag should be a single word. Okay. Next, the tags are nested. Before closing the outer tag, inner tag should be closed first. Clear? And the next one is white spaces are not allowed. Always, tag should be a single word. This space should be not allowed inside the tag. And the next, if you are writing any tag, if you have written any tag wrongly, and browser if it does not understood any tag, then what happened? Browser just it won't throw any error, but it won't display that information. Okay, just browser simply ignore that. Clear? So this is about tags. What are the tags? Tags are coding instructions. Whatever you want to include on the browser window using HTML, all those should be included between a tags only. Clear? Now the next one is types of tags. Types of tags means how many types of tags we have. See, in HTML there are two types of tags. The first one is paired, that P-A-I-R-E-D, paired, and it is a unpaired tag. Close. You write down this, you take screenshot, or else you take screenshot. How many types of tags we have? Paired and unpaired. Okay, two types of tags you have, and sometimes you can expect this question in short because it is a small only. Frequently they used to ask this question in a short. Okay, how many types of tags we have? Two types. One is a paired tag and the second one is an unpaired tag. Clear? Now we'll discuss about paired and unpaired tag. Okay, first one is paired. Okay, what is the paired? Paired means what? Two. Okay, so if one tag is there and for that tag, closing tag is also there. Or we can say that if the closing tag is compulsory, then such tags are called as a paired tag, like this. HTML is the opening and you can give HTML closing. Okay, so this is a opening tag and this is a closing tag. Okay, so for any tag, if there is a closing tag is also there, then such tags are called as a paired tag. HTML, title, head, that is HTML. Title is also paired tag. And it is also paired tag. Means for that tag, closing is there. Closing is compulsory. Such tags are called as a paired tag. If any tag contains closing tag is also, then that tags are called as a paired tag. Okay. Now, the next one is a unpaired tag. Okay, what is the next one? Unpaired. In the name itself, we have a definition. We have some tags in HTML. For that tags, there is no closing tag. See, if there is a closing tag, then that is called as a paired. If there is no closing tag, then that is called as an unpaired tag. If there is in HTML we have some tags, for that tags closing tags are not there, such tags are called as a unpaired tag. There is no closing tag, such tags are called as a unpaired tag. Example, break is there. For this tag there is no closing tag. Next, img is the image. For image is also no closing tag. HR is there, horizontal ruler. But that tag also, there is no closing tag. So if any tag does not have a closing tag, then such tags are called as a unpaired tag. If any tag is contained closing tag, that tags are called as a paired tags. Okay, understood? So this is about tags. Means what are the tags? What are the rules of the tags? And how many types of tags? Okay, so maximum you can expect this question in short because it is very small. Okay, so what are the tags? Tags are coding instructions. This tags guides the browser how to display the content if the user is added any content. Okay, and what are the rules here? tag should be in angle bracket and it is not case sensitive. You can add any content and closing is compulsory. And if there is a paired tag, then the closing tag should have a forward slash, and white spaces are not allowed. And if the browser does not understand any tag, simply it will ignore it. Okay, so those are the rules you need to follow when you are writing any tag. Now come to the next types of tags. Means how many types of tags we have? In HTML there are two types of tags. One is an unpaired tag, and the second one is a paired tag. Okay, paired means what? Two. For any tag, if there is a closing tag is also there, then that is called as a unpaired tag. Okay, what is the difference between opening and closing? Closing tag ends with a forward slash. And if it is an unpaired tag, for that tag, there is no closing. Clear? Such tags are called as a unpaired tags. Okay, so this is about tags. In the next class, we'll discuss about the structure of, means what elements you have in HTML. When you are writing any program, what elements you need to include, and what is the sequence, and what is the structure, in what way, in which structure you need to include that HTML elements, that we'll discuss in the next class.